Well, Josh, the search effort is just winding down as we speak right now. We just had one boat came over shore and dropped somebody off. A second boat, search boat, is coming in here to the landing area. They're going to be wrapping this up very, very shortly. Fish and Game officials say that yesterday, the Connecticut River here had lots of debris. The currents were very, very swift, and the conditions were very dangerous. A search party of 20 people, 7 boats, 2 canine teams, and a state police helicopter are combing the frigid waters of the Connecticut River for 65-year-old Alan Benjamin. Authorities say the Vermont man went kayaking yesterday, and at this point, officials say, is presumed drowned.
We exhausted avenues in that where we feel he may have survived it and gotten to land. The area that we're talking about along the Connecticut River here is surrounded by 2 major road systems and several houses. The area has also been searched from the air, and we haven't been able to locate any clue of Mr. Benjamin.
Fish and Game officials say Benjamin contacted his sister Thursday morning and told her he was going kayaking. Authorities found his vehicle at a launch point in North Thetford, Vermont. His empty kayak was found 14 miles downriver in Hanover.
We're following up on a witness account who may have actually seen Mr. Benjamin in the kayak around the Thetford Bridge in the afternoon yesterday. So that, if that's validated, we can then potentially make the search area down about 3.5 miles. Still a very large search area to try and cover.
The center of the river runs about 25 feet deep. The water temperature is somewhere in the mid to upper 30s. A local power company is controlling an upriver dam to help in the search, but conditions overall are tough.
Visibility is very poor. You can only see a foot or two into the water just because it's very cloudy. As far as the speed of the water, it's actually dropped down quite a bit.
We can see behind me now that actually 3 of these search boats are actually coming to this launching point. They're going to be wrapping up for the day, and we heard from Fish and Game officials earlier who said that they're not sure if they will continue their search efforts, at least on this scale, tomorrow. Reporting live in Hanover, I'm Andy Hirschberger, WMUR News 9.